we are going to shoot a two-view chest x-ray. Two-view chest x-ray consists of a PA projection and a lateral projection. So before we start that, we'll actually get the room ready for before our patient comes in. So I had already detented our tube to 72 inches to the Bucky. So from there, we'll add a 14 by 17 cassette crosswise for a male, and we'll do a crosswise or landscape for male, portrait for a female. So once we get a understanding of who our patient is, we will change that to that. So now that our room is set up, we're detented. We are set for the wall bucky. I am going to go get our patient. Come on in. How you doing today?
Good. How are you?
Good. So today you were going to do a couple of chest x-rays. So what brings you in today?
I have a shortness of breath.
Shortness of breath?
Yeah.
Okay. How long has that been going on for?
A week.
About a week now? Okay. And can you do me a favor and verify your name for me?
First name John, last name Chen.
John Chen, okay.
Yeah.
And your date of birth?
1190.
So what I did was I asked the patient to go ahead and verify his birthday and his name to what I have on my requisite, and it all matches up. So I'm going to ask my... So now that I have a little bit of a history, that he's had shortness of breath, it's going on for a week, we can kind of note that. So going forward, I would ask the patient if he's had any prior history of high blood pressure, diabetes, or any other type of chest surgeries or just surgeries in general. Have you had any of those in the past?
No.
No? Okay. So I'm going to actually have you remove any articles or any necklaces or any artifacts. If we had a female patient, we would ask her to remove her bra or just basically anything from the waist up that would show an artifact in the image. I'm going to give you this gown, and you can go ahead and put that on in the dressing room, and just go ahead and come back when you're ready.
Okay.
Now that I have a understanding of who my patient is, I am going to leave the Bucky IR the way it is, crosswise chest, and I'm going to go set my technique, and I'll probably set it at 110, about 8. He's a smaller individual, so he's not very big, so we don't need that much mass. So I'm going to go ahead and set that now. And then I'm going to go check on our patient and make sure he's okay. So I'm going to ask our patient to face the IR here, the wall bucky. So, sir, can you please just kind of stand right in front of there? What I'm looking for is at my center beam. And actually, I'm going to have to move over a little bit just because I want it to be more mid-sagittal. So I'm just going to kind of lightly place him, move him over. And I'm looking for his T7, which would be border of his scapula, which is about there. So I'll move there. Make sure that we're centered to the IR, so that we can always center there. We want to make sure we have enough, anywhere from 1 to 2 inches above each shoulders, because I'm going to ask him, when I ask him to do his breathing technique, he's going to roll his shoulders forward for me, and that will bring up the shoulders up a little bit, so I still want some light above the shoulders, and I think everything looks good there. And all we have to do now is place our correct marker and we want to make sure that the marker is out of any NMA, out of the lung field, mainly. So from there, I think we look good. I'm going to instruct our patient to take 2 deep breaths, and on the second breath, he's going to hold it. So, Mr. Chan, can you take 2 deep breaths for me? Let it out. Go ahead one more time. And I want you to suspend that breath, and then we'll take the x-ray, okay? So go ahead and relax right now. And from behind the wall, I will instruct you to take a deep breath, okay? So now I'm going to go take our x-ray. Okay, Mr. Chan, 2 deep breaths. And hold it. X-ray. Go ahead and relax, Mr. Chan. Go ahead and just go ahead and stand at ease. So now I will take my image and go develop at the PAC system. And at that time, while that's developing, I will change my technique for a lateral, and we'll reposition our patient. Okay, so now that image is running, I can set up our next image, which will be a lateral. So we're gonna go, portrait. So we're gonna have our patient now face me. Turn this way for me, Ms. Chan, and I'm going to have you put your left shoulder up against the IR there, and I want to see if you can get your arms up over your head. If you can, we have an assistant here. We can use a pole if you can't do that, but that's what this is here for. We have an elderly patient who can use a little help. So again, we want to reposition our patient. We want our center beam to come mid-coronal here and inferior to our scapula border again, our scapula. So you kind of palpitate for our scapula, and I'm actually going to have them take a step forward for me. Actually, if you want to take another step forward for me. So now I got my IR center from mid-coronal, so you can look at his ear and kind of just that. See if that's centered. And we want a little bit of light showing behind our patient, which I do have a little bit of light here. And we're just gonna slightly rotate them. So we want our posterior ribs to be superimposed on each other. I think we're good there. Again, we wanna use our correct marker. So this time it's gonna be our left marker. Again, out of any anatomy. So we'll place it there, still in the lung field. And again, I'm going to instruct our patient to do the same breathing technique, 2 deep breaths, hold on the second breath. So, Mr. Chan, again, one more time, 2 deep breaths, and hold it on the second one, okay? So, at this point, I have changed my technique to a lateral technique. So, we are at 110 at 10 now. So, we just up the mass a little bit, just because we have a little bit more tissue and bone to get through. So just one more time, we'll check to make sure our centroid is looking good. And from there, we'll take our x-ray. Mr. Chan, 2 deep breaths for me. Hold it. X-ray. Go ahead and relax, Mr. Chan. You're all done. So now, I'll just have our patient just relax while I go and develop this one to make sure everything's good. And if we're good, our patient is all done. Okay, Mr. Chan, we're all done for today. You can go ahead and get dressed again, and I'll walk you up back out to the waiting room. Thank you.